Right. Okay. So, good morning, everyone. Good morning, students. As Dr. Nilesh has showed you how to access the subject-based e-resources from the library portal, so you can see here the library portal. I've clicked on pathology. Okay. Again, there are three resources. We have Access Medicine, Clinical Key, and TM. Okay. So we'll start with Access Medicine. Again, I think. Many of the students here might be in year one and maybe the beginning of year two. Okay, so we'll focus more on the textbooks, right? So there are two resources. One is the pathology textbook. This is the big picture from pathology, right? And the other one is a modern case study from Lange. This is more useful if you are like, you know, sort of preparing for cases or for, you know, towards your first professional part one examination, where we have questions which are more case based. Yeah, so I'll just go on to the big picture. I've already opened it, so you can see there are chapters here, 20 odd chapters covered. Sorry for that. Okay, so 20 odd chapters covering the entire range of pathology. Yeah, for the early semesters, for example, semester one, okay, where we'll be focusing more on general pathology. Yeah, so you can see I've clicked on cellular pathology, right? And you can see there are, you know, this the entire chapter covering all the various aspects of cellular pathology is here. All right. Again, if you can actually sign in via Shibboleth, okay, using your username and password. If you don't have, if you're having any issues, again, you can contact the librarian and they should be able to help you to get to access this resource. Okay, so this is a very good resource. Once you've actually registered with this, then the next time you go automatically, you just need to key in your username and password, and then it'll take you to this page where you can access all these resources. Okay, so very detailed resource. You can even actually download the chapter as a PDF, okay, for your further reading. I've also opened the modern case study, right? Again, you can see there are a number of chapters covering the whole of pathology, all the systems, right? So maybe let's look at cell injury, cell death, and aging, because this is something that we cover in the earlier semesters. Right, so again, you can see you have access to the chapter, access to the figures. At the top, you can download the chapter PDF once you have signed in. All right, and it gives you a very detailed overview of the various aspects of cellular injury. All right, okay, so something similar to the big picture, right? Again, where you have a number of chapters. Again, like I said, once you register with this with Access Medicine, you should be able to access all these materials. Okay, so two textbooks under Access Medicine. One is the big picture, and the other one is this modern case study. Okay, right. So those are two textbooks. Let's look at Clinical Key. Again, we have books, book chapters, videos, and images that you can access. Okay, we'll look at what are the books available. Some of these may not be very much relevant at this early stage of your medical program, right? Nonetheless, if you're more interested, for example, you could look into the head and neck pathology of a student when they go to the year two and they have the forensic medicine module. Yeah, then you can actually use the autopsy pathology because this one is focusing more on that. Okay, so you can see a lot of details on, you know, what are the things we do normally in a autopsy. Okay, so this is very good, especially when you are coming to your end of year two or beginning of year three. All right. Okay, so a lot of information available on the various aspects of autopsy. Okay, let's go back. Okay, so four books are here. One is the gynecological surgical pathology. Again, will be useful when you're probably looking at your resources when you're doing the reproductive module. This is an atlas of liver pathology, more useful when you're doing your GIT module, right? And head and neck is covered under the central nervous system module. Okay, so this resource could be useful for that, right? So four atlases are available. Again, you can even access the images that are there in that resource. Okay, we'll go on to TM. Now, TM has images, video, audio. Okay, we'll look at the ebooks, right? So this also has five books there. I've also showed microbiology because microbiology is also a very important component of pathology, right? So you can see there's a book on medical microbiology and also a microbiology in a pocket, basically a review resource that you can use for microbiology. Okay, three books are available for pathology. One is a color atlas of pathophysiology. The other one is for pathology and the third one is for hematology. Okay, we look at the one for pathology, right? So again, you can see here, okay, takes you through a number of content, all right? Okay, if you want to look at the content, you can do so, or you can even click on the images. Okay, so you can see there are a number of images that are available, both histopathology as well as cytopathology. All right, okay, so that's one. The other one is on pathophysiology. Okay, so you can see it again covers a number of systems as well. All right. And here as well, you can access all the various images that are related to the pathophysiology of a particular disease, right? These images may be useful for you to, study better about the pathophysiology, okay? Or maybe when you want to do a presentation, like when we have case-based learning sessions, students are actually asked to prepare for questions as well. Right, so you could use some of these resources to prepare for those kind of presentations. Okay, so things like PBL, CBL, where students are asked to come out with present certain learning issues or answer certain questions, these kind of images can be very, very useful. Okay, so either you can put this in a document, share them with your peers, which can then be used to even show as a presentation. All right, and there's also a color atlas of hematology. The hematology module in the MBBS program is in year one, right? So again, you can see it covers the entire range of the hematology module. Okay, so the normal cells, the white cell series, okay, the RBCs and the thrombocytes, and also looks at the cytology of various organ biopsies. Okay, so a lot of images that are available not only to both faculty and also students, which can be used to read and be better prepared when, especially when you're dealing with your exams and those kind of things. All right, okay, so these are easily accessible if you do have any issues with logging in this. Please don't think twice to write back to Kagzu or even Razman, okay, to get clarifications on how to log in.